Hello friends, welcome back. My name is PK. In this video, you will learn how to create an inventory management template for a store. So friends, this template is useful when you have hundreds or thousands of small products and you are keeping your product inside such kind of drawer. When the customer will come to your shop or store, it will be difficult to remember which product you have kept in which drawer. Friends, I have created this sheet wherein you can manage your inventory as well as you can search your product where you have kept it. So let me explain you this template first. So on the top we have given the high level information, what is the current stock for overall products, the stock value and the stock cost, then how many products should be reordered, it is saying 10 products, and how many is out of stock. That means we don't have even single unit of the product. So this is the count of such product. Then we can search a specific product. So when we have, let's say, 100 or 1000 products in our product master and we want to search a particular product where it is available, what is the current stock, and you can add the inventory or you can move out the inventory. If you want to see all the products here, you can simply click on this button, current stock. Now it is displaying all the product with all the information like opening stock, in, out, closing stock, stock value, stock cost. This is the reorder label for each product, and reorder is required or not, it will say yes or no. And then the drawer number where you have placed this particular product. You can see the list of the product which should be reordered. So you can simply click on this button. So here it is displaying the list of these 10 products. If you want to see all the products which is out of stock, you can simply click here. So this is the list of those products which is out of stock. Now if you want to search any specific product, you can simply click on search button. Then this search form will be opened, and here we have the list of all products available in our sheet. You can check it from here or you can type in search box. So let's say I want to search box. I have typed here box, then these two products are coming with the text box. I can click here simply. Then you can see as soon as I will select that product, it is showing the current stock is 36, reorder required, no, and drawer number is 5. So you can quickly go to the drawer number 5 and you can open that drawer and you can take the product and you can sell to customer. Similarly, if I will click here, it is showing that current stock is 2, reorder is required, and it is available in drawer number 3. So as you will select any product and you will move down, then these numbers will be changed. Alright friend, you can see more details. So just select any product, you can double click on this or you can click on see more details. Then what will happen, it will show on this sheet that particular product. So you can see the further detail like what was the opening stock, in, out, closing stock, stock value, stock cost, reorder label, reorder required, no, and the drawer number. Alright. We have some other sheets here like product master wherein you can enter your product details. So just enter your all products here. You can put the cost per unit and the price per unit also. Then you can keep the drawer number. So what you can do, let's say if you have 100 drawers with you, you can put some check there with the number, and the same number you can put here. If you are keeping multiple product, 3, 4 or 5 product inside single drawer, you can put the same number in front of those 4 or 5 products. Then you can give some reorder label also. So according to your sale, you can put some reorder label number. Now I'll show you the next sheet, which is stock in out. This sheet will be managed by that particular form, or you can manage it manually also. Here we have some formulas, so you don't worry about that. You just need to fill it down, or it will be filled by that particular form only. In the starting, you can keep your opening stock for each product. You can put any date and then you can put, okay, how many units available with you in your shop or in your store. Now I'll show you the inventory also. Again, this is automatic sheet. You don't need to do anything here. Only thing, when the new product will come, you can simply put that product name here. We have put the formulas here, you can see on the top. automatically it will pick up that. Alright, then we are coming to the report part, so you don't need to do anything here. Now I'll show you, let's say this particular product which is battery cap, we have closing stock 21. Reorder level is 9. For this particular product, if I will move the inventory, let's say 20, then it should come in the reorder. Reorder count will be 11. So let me show you. If I will click on add, then update inventory form will be opened. And here let's type this product which is battery cap, or just type cap. Then we have this battery cap here. Just select this and just click on this button or double click on this. As soon as I will click here, then product name will be displayed here. We want to out this. We will select this out and how many quantity. As of now, we have 21. So let's say I'm saying we have sold 20 quantity on this date. Or you can use the calendar to select the date here, 18, 19 or whatever you want to select. For now, I'm just keeping it as it is. Now I'll submit this and just close this. Now here you can see in the reorder, now we have the count 11. If I will click here, then you can see this battery cap is available here, this line. Alright, or if you want to search again, or just search the battery cap, it is available here. You can see, just double click or click on see more details. So just double click here, then it is showing the information here. Now we have out 20. Alright, so now closing stock is only 1. So friends, that's how you can manage your inventory using these forms. Now I will tell you step by step how can you quickly create this template in Microsoft Excel. So first what I have done, I have taken this product master sheet, and in this sheet we have these 5 columns. One is the product name, wherein you can put your product name, then cost per unit, price per unit, droid number and reorder level. Like I have explained you, this is the cost when you purchase this product from your supplier, then what was the cost per unit for this product, you can put it here. If then here you can put price per unit, this is the price on which price you will sell this product to your customer, that price should come here. Then droid number, if you have multiple droids with you and you can put some cheat like this picture where you want to keep this particular product, so you can put the droid number. If you are keeping multiple product inside a single droid, you can put the same droid number in front of that product. Alright, then the order label also you can. So this is the simple sheet we can keep. So let me copy this and let me add a new workbook. Press Ctrl N. I will paste this here. Rename this as Product Master. Alright, now come to the second sheet. In the second sheet, we have product name in out and date and quantity. Then we have some other information also. Let me copy this header and let's add a new sheet and just paste this header here. First, we will enter opening stock for each product. So let's paste this here. And here we can rename the sheet like we have put here stock in out. The same sheet name, we will keep this here. And we can create a drop down here. So let's select this and press Alt DL or go to the data and you can go to the validation and data validation. And here you can select list. So first, let me put here opening stock. Then we can put here in, then out. Alright. Now here we can select opening stock for the first time. You can put the starting date from when you are going to start this template. So let's put here 1st Jan 2021. Then put your quantity or number of units you have available with you for this particular product. For now, I'm just putting some random number, or I can just copy this number available already there. So let me paste this here. Then the price per unit. We have the price per unit there. So we can use the VLOOKUP formula simple from the product master. I'll use here VLOOKUP. Then lookup value, I'll give this product name. Then I'll go to the product master and I will select price. This is the cost. Then this is the price, the third one. So put here 3, 0. Let's see again. So the third column, this is the price per unit. Alright. Similarly, here we can put the total value will be price per unit multiply number of unit or quantity. then the cost per unit will be, again we will use the VLOOKUP. Lookup value, I'll take this product name, then I'll go to the product master and I will select here A to B and put 2, 0. Close the bracket. This is cost per unit. Now I will multiply this cost per unit by number of units or quantity. So we have put all the formulas here. We can fill this down. Alright, so we have created two sheets. Now the third sheet is the inventory sheet. This one. Inventory sheet we are using to manage the inventory and to show it in the report. So here we have taken these headers. Let me copy all the headers first and let me add a sheet here and just paste those headers here. And this will be our inventory. Here we will copy all the products from the product master, only product name, and paste this here. Now for all other fields we will use the formulas only. For the opening stock we will use SUMIFS function. SUMIFS, first of all we will give the sum range, so we'll go to the stock in out and here we will take this range which is D quantity, comma, then the criteria range 1, so I'll select this in out and here I will put opening stock, comma, then product name and here this time I'll give this reference of the product. So press enter. Sorry, the reference would come from inventory sheet, this one. Okay, so this is the opening stock. Now similarly we can calculate in out. What I will do, I'll copy the same formula here. In column C we will use, in place of opening stock, use in. And here in place of opening stock I will use out. Okay, and the closing stock will be opening stock plus in minus out. So whatever available stock with you and then you have purchased and then minus whatever you have sold. Press enter. So this will be our closing stock. Now the stock value, use here VLOOKUP. Lookup value will take the product name, then go to the product master and select this range. And we know price per unit available in column number 3, so use here 3, 0 and just close the bracket. So this is the price per unit, but we need stock value. So what we will do, we will multiply it by the closing stock. Press enter. We will use the similar formula here in the stock cost also. In place of 3 in the VLOOKUP we'll use the 2 because in the product master the cost per unit available in column B. Alright, so we have stock cost also. Now reorder level. Reorder level we will use the VLOOKUP formula again. Use the VLOOKUP product name as a lookup value, comma, product master and select this range, reorder available on column number 5. So put here comma 5, comma 0, close the bracket. Now reorder required. So we will use here if this reorder label is greater than or equal to this closing stock, then we will say yes, else we will say no. So we are saying if my closing stock and the reorder label is equal to or my closing stock is less than reorder level, then I will put here yes because reorder will be required, otherwise I will put here no. Just close the bracket, press enter. So it is saying no because we have 31 units available with us and reorder level is 6. Alright, now drawer number, we will again use the VLOOKUP, lookup value, product name and then product master, select this range, this time we will take 4, press enter. Now copy these formulas and just paste in the other cells also. So we have all the values with us. Alright, we will create our report. Add one more sheet here and just rename this as report. In the report page, we will quickly create these boxes to display these numbers first of all. All the numbers will come from the inventory sheet. So what I will do, I'll add another sheet here and I'll keep the name as support. And here we will take current stock, stock value, stock cost, reorder and out of stock. So just put here. Alright, so we have put all the text here. Now we will put the formulas here. So for the current stock I'll use sum And then I'll go to the inventory and I'll take the sum of closing stock, which will be my current stock. Press enter. Then stock value, again I will use sum, and inventory I'll take the sum of stock value. Press enter. For the stock cost, I'll use sum, and then I'll go to the inventory, I'll take the sum of stock cost. Press enter. Then the reorder, so I'll use here count if. Then range, I'll take this range, and here I will count yes. So wherever yes is available, it should return that count. Get the count of out of stock, so again I will use count if. And I'll go to the inventory sheet, and this time I'll count the column E. Wherever 0 is available, count of 0. Alright, so we have put it here. Now, to put it in proper boxes, so here you can put your header. So let me select this range, go to the home, merge and center. You can put here inventory management template, make it slightly bigger. You can put some background color. Let's take this one, background white. Font you can take this one. Alright, now just go to the view and remove the grid lines from here. Now we will create few boxes. So I'll go to the insert, then I'll go to the shapes, and I'll take this rounded rectangle, this one. Just drag this rectangle here. You can take any color. So I have taken here this white color background. Then shape outline, you can choose any outline. So let's take this gray one. Then shape effects, you can go to the shadow. Let's take this shadow, which is offset center. Alright. Now go to the insert and go to the text box, and you can drag a text box here and just click on the border of this text box. Go to the formula bar, press equal to, then go to this support sheet. So first of all, I'll click on this current stock A1. Now it will show me that current stock here. Now I will format this, align this center and make it slightly smaller like this, and just move this here. Make a copy of this and paste this here. We will change the reference. In place of A1, we will take B1 and just press enter. So here you can see on the support sheet, B1 is the current stock count. So it is displaying the current stock count. We will keep this here. You can change the color if you want, make this bold. You can take, let's say this color, or let's take this color. You can make slightly bigger. So it will look like this. Similarly, we will create the other boxes and we will connect with these references A2, A3, A4, A5 and similarly with the numbers. Alright, so we have created all the boxes. We want to give the same formatting. We'll select this text box, go to the format painter, double click here, then just click, click, click and click, and just press escape. So we have created all the boxes. Now quickly we will select this rectangle, then the other text boxes, and right click, make it group. Similarly, we will do for the other boxes also. Alright. Now let's align this. Left all together, go to the save format, align this top, then distribute this horizontally. Now here we will copy this heading, the inventory heading, and we will paste this here from the row number 7. We'll select all the boxes, right click, go to the size and properties, then we'll go to the properties, and here we will select this don't move or size with these cells. Now select these columns and make slightly bigger. Alright, so now select this cell A8, go to the view, and here we'll go to the freeze fence and just click on freeze fence. So it is freeze. If I will scroll it down, you can see these top number will not get changed. Now we will save this file as macro enabled. So just click on save. Let's say I'm saving it in documents and I'm saving it as macro enabled. Just click on save. Now we will write few macros. So here let me quickly explain you from this worksheet. So we have created few forms. So let's go to the Visual Basic of this sheet, which is inventory management template for store. We have used this calendar, to display the calendar. I have already created few videos on this topic, how to create this calendar in VBA, how to integrate with your project this calendar. Alright. Then we have designed this search product form, and then we have designed this update inventory form. So let's quickly design first of all this search product form. Design a new form from the starting. So I'll insert this form. I'll make it slightly bigger, and I'll take this frame. So let's drag this frame. In this frame, I'll take a text box first. So just drag that text box here. This will be my search box. Right click, go to the properties. You can change the style if you want to change. So I'm just changing the special effect, and let's say I'm taking this one. Or then I'll take a list box. So this is the list box. Just drag a list box here. So here I will display my products. Alright. Just right click, go to the properties. Will provide the same special effect here. We will make a copy of this frame, and I will paste this here. Just keep this here. And we will take few labels. So the first label we will take here, let's say current stock. Format this, right click, go to the properties, and you can align this center. You can change the font slightly bigger, make this bold, or let's take around 14. Make a copy of this and paste here, and just keep this here, and we will put the caption as simple dash. Right click, go to the properties, you can make it slightly more bigger, let's take 20. You can change the font color also from here for color, so let's take this color. And you can change the name also, so for this we are putting LBL current stock. Alright, now quickly we will make a copy of this, copy and paste, and again paste, so we have three different copies. For the second one, we will keep a reorder, whether reorder is required or not. And we will change the name of this one, keep as LBL reorder. And for this one, we will keep the caption as drawer number. Here we will keep LBL. Alright, so we have make those changes, and you can change the user form name also. Right click, go to the properties. So let's keep the similar user form which we have kept here. This is FRM search product. Alright, you can change the frame caption also. This is frame 1. Right click, go to the properties. You can keep here search, and for the second one we can keep the report. Alright, so this is ready, and now I'll show you how it will work. The only thing is we can provide one button also here. Just go to this toolbox, and then you can drag a button here like this, and just rename this. So that's how we have designed this form. Now quickly I will start the coding part here. So just double click on this user form, and first I will create sub so product. So first of all we will display the product in this list box. So to show the product, what I will do, I'll use dim sh as worksheet, and set sh equal to this workbook dot seats, and here I will use product master. Now I'll use dim I as integer, and I will use a loop here. So I'll use for I equal to, I'll use 2 2, and I'll use application dot worksheet function, and I'll use here count a function. We'll get how many rows are available in this product master seat. So I'll use here ss dot range a to a. Next I, and then here I'll use me dot list box 1 dot add item, and we will add ss dot range a and I. We know our product name is available on column a. Alright, so if I will call this on user form activation, so just click on activate and just call this here. Now let me run this form. So you can see all the products are available here, because all the products are available on column A of product master. So we have added this here. Now the only thing is, if we want to search any product, if I will type anything here, let's say box, then that should be filtered. So how we can do that? So what I will do, I'll make some changes here. First of all, so that change will be, I'll check if me dot textbox 1 dot value equal to blank, then only it will add this product simply otherwise I'll use here else, and if otherwise we will check whatever text we have put inside the text box, is that available in the product name or not. So I'll use here if in str formula. So here we have to provide the complete text, so I'll use here ss.range a and I, and then the text which we want to search, that will be me.textbox1.value. If it is returning greater than 0, that means that particular text is available there, then we will add it. So I'll use here this one, all right. But for this we have to call this on the change event of this text box. So double click here and then you can see the change event has been generated. So let me call this here. Before adding this, so we should use me.listbox1.clear. Alright, so let's run this. Now here if I will type box, alright, so it is filtering. Now if I will select this, then you can see the numbers are not being displayed here. So what we will do here, we will make some other changes. So double click on this, so list box click event has been generated, but we will put this on list box change event. Just select the change event from the list and just delete this. So what I will do here, if me dot list box list index, if list index is greater than or equal to 0, else it will display that dash there. So here in else case we have not selected any item. Me dot LBL current stock dot caption dash, and for the other also me dot LBL drawer number dot caption equal to this dash, me dot LBL reorder dot caption equal to dash. But what if we have selected a product, then these captions should be changed. So what I will do, I'll copy and paste this here, and we will use here VLOOKUP formula. So let me close this and I'll show you how to use the VLOOKUP here. I'll use here application dot worksheet function dot VLOOKUP. So first we will provide the lookup range, so which will be my me dot listbox one dot value, whatever we have selected, comma, then we will use the worksheet range. So first we are providing the current stock, so I'll go to the inventory and from here I'll use the VLOOKUP column A to E. So what we can do, we can define the worksheet here, dim sh as worksheet, and set sh equal to this workbook dot seats, and here we will use inventory. Alright, so now this seat we will use sh dot range, and we will use A to, we can use the whole range from A to J. Now the numbers we will choose for the current stock, we will choose number 5, column E. Then the drawer number will be 10, and then the order required will be I, which is 9. So I'll use here A to J, comma. First I'll put here 5, comma 0. Just close the bracket. And let me copy the same formula and just paste this here and just paste this here. This time I'll use for the drawer number 10, and the order I'll take from 9. Alright, so let me run this. If I will select any product, then you can see it is returning the values, but the text is not properly visible. So let me make little bit bigger. Alright, so that's how you can search this. You want to search any product. Okay, so it's working perfect. So that's how you can use the search form. Now I'll show you how can you quickly design this update inventory form. What we can do, we can make a copy of this form. I'll tell you how can you make a copy of the existing form. So what you can do, just add a new workbook, press Ctrl N, then you can see book 2 has been added. So now let's go to the Visual Basic, and here you will see that book 2 is available. So let's move this form to book 2. In the book 2, right click on the form, go to the properties, and you can change the name. So this time let's keep update inventory. Alright, and then we can move it back to book 1. So that's how we can copy our form. Now we can close this book 2 from here. Just close this. Now if you will see, that form is available here. In the first form we forgot to put the code on C more details. So here let me show you here in the C more details. So we have called this search product. So in the search product, what we have, this code. So let me copy this quickly and just go to the this form, double click here, and we can add this support feature here. I'll quickly explain this. First of all, we are checking whether a product has been selected in the list box or not. Otherwise, it will return this message. Then we are copying the data. So we are using two sheet here, the SH as worksheet and RSH as worksheet. And here we are using the SH as worksheet and we are taking the inventory sheet. And here we are taking the report sheet. So let me show you. In the inventory sheet, we have this information and in the report sheet, we don't have any information. So first, what we are doing from, you can see from the report sheet from row number 8. So row number 8 is this one. Till the end of the row, we are removing all the data. If any data is already available there, we are removing that. Then what we are doing, we are putting some filter. So for that particular product, whatever we have selected, we are putting the filter here in the inventory sheet. And then we are copying that information and we are pasting as value and format on the report sheet. Then we are removing the filter and activating the A1 cell and hiding the form. Call this on that particular button also. Just call this here. Now if I will run, then what will happen? So let's say I have selected this, and if I'm saying see more details, then what is happening? It is just updating that information here, just copying the data from the inventory sheet for that particular product and putting it here. Now I quickly design this update inventory form. In the update inventory form, just copy and this here, this command button. This is just to move product name, and let's remove this all information from here. Just keep only this button, like we have put this here, the submit button, and then we will create a product name box, then in out option button and quantity, and quickly take a label. Here we will put product name. Then let's take this text box, or you can copy it from here. This will be my product name. Then I'll take two option button for in and out. This will be for in. Just copy this and paste, and this will be for out. We can put the default value for in. Right click, go to the properties and just put the value as true here. So it will be selected, you can see. Alright, then make a copy of this label and just put this here. This will be quantity. Copy this box and paste. Make a copy and paste this here. This will be my date. And we can copy the same button for the date. This is just a image. Alright. Alright. So we can rename the caption of this frame also. This is to update inventory. For this form also, this is not the search product. This is update inventory. Now we will start our coding part here. So the coding to search a product will remain same. We will delete this code first. Now we can search it from here. Let's say box, so it is available. And when we will click on this button, that particular should be added here. So what we will do, we'll see what code we have written here. We'll use the same code. You can see this is the small code. Just copy this and just go to this. Double click and you can paste it here. So here we are just checking whether we have selected a product or not. Then whatever we have selected on the list box, that particular name will be available in the text box too. So let me show you. If I will click here, then it will be available here, but it should not be editable now. So what I will do, I'll select this one and date also. Right click, go to the properties, and I will make them disabled. So enabled is true. Just double click, it will be disabled. Now run. If I will add, then you can see it is disabled. And default date value we will use today's date. So double click on the form and here we will put if me.textbox4 is the date textbox. So I'll use if me.textbox4.value. If it is blank, then I'll use me.textbox4.value equal to, use here format, date, and I'll show in the format of putting inverted comma dd mmm yes bye close, and if alright. Now let's run this, so you can see today's date will be available there. Okay, so this is almost done. Now just rename this as submit. Okay, so now I'll show you what code I have put on the submit button. Just double click and just copy this from here. And same code we will put here. And I will explain you step by step. First, we have put the validation. If textbox2, which is the product name, if it is blank, then it is saying please add a product into product box. And if quantity is not numeric, which is textbox3, then it is saying invalid quantity. So make sure we have given the correct input. Then I have used SH as worksheet for stock in out sheet. Then I have used LR as long. So I want to get the last row available on stock in out sheet, because this data will be updated in stock in out sheet. Then here we are using sh.range, which is stock in out sheet, a and lr.value. So here we are putting the product name on the column A. So let me show you this sheet. So whatever is the last row, then we are using plus one. So it is putting product here. Then column B we will put in or out. So you can see in the column B, first we are checking if we have selected option button 1, then we will put in column B in, otherwise we will put out. Similarly, in column C and D, we have put here date and here we have put quantity. Once we have put all the information, then we are filling down the formula and we are saying this message. Now I'll show you how can you show the calendar. So to show the calendar, we'll use here image 2 and just put here click event, and we will call. We have not moved the calendar here, so first let's move this calendar here. You can download this calendar from my website. I'll provide the link in video description box. It is absolutely free. Now here I will use call calendar.selectedDate. To know more about the calendar.selectedDate, you can watch our previous videos which I have created how to create this calendar in VBA. So here I will put the target control name, which is me.textbox4. So here I have put the date. Now let me run. If I will click, then you can see calendar is available here. Whatever date I will select, that will be available here. You can select in out here. If you select any product, just click, or you can search any product name here. Let's say box and this here, and then you can put the quantity and you can submit that. All right, that will be updated. All right, so as soon as you will update, so one reorder is displaying, you can see. Now we have put two buttons there. So to put the buttons, we have used one module. So let me move this module here and I will show you all the codes which I have put. So first, to show the search form, so I have used frm search form dot show and false, so model will be false. And here to show the inventory, so you can add two buttons here. So let me add quickly two rectangles, right click, assign macro, this workbook, and here first we will show for search form this one. And right click, this will be for assign macro for show update inventory form. If I will click here, it will display this update inventory form. If I will click here, it will display this search form. Alright. We have created few other macros. Current stock. So you can see this is the same code which we have used to show the more details of the product. So this is the same code. Here we have taken two worksheet variables. Then we have assigned the SS to inventory and RSS to report. So let me show you the sheet once again. This inventory is SH, then this is RSH. And here what we have done, first we have cleared all the rows from row number 8. From here we have cleared all the rows. Then we have removed if any filter available on the inventory sheet. And simply we have copied all the data available on the inventory sheet and we have pasted from the row number 7 from here. Alright, now what I will do, I'll right click here and this is the current stock macro. Right click, assign macro on this, and we will this workbook and we will assign the current stock. If I will click, then you can see it is displaying all the data here. Alright, then similarly we have created for the reorder one. The only difference, we have put here a filter. And that filter is column number 9, we have put yes and product should not be blank. So we have put two filters here. So for the reorder, this one, right click and I will assign, and I'll assign the reorder, this one. So if I will click, it will display only one item. So whatever number will be available here, that will be displayed. Similarly, for the out of stock, the column number 5, which is closing stock, we are taking 0. And product should not be blank. So we can assign this here. Right click, assign. This will be out of stock. So as of now, it is 0. If I will click, no record will appear. Alright friends. So friends, that's how you can create this inventory management template. It is very useful for the different type of store like medical store, auto parts store, or any other store wherein you have hundreds or thousands of small products. Alright friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and please subscribe my channel to get the regular update of my videos. Thank you so much for watching.